Today, I want to show you a new feature in Riverside that allows you to add music, background music for your episode, for your intros and outros, and or background sound. So let's have a look in the new editor where to find this. It's quite easy to do if you have the new editor in Riverside, which I think has been rolled out to everybody already. You can look at the bottom here and you see this new track called Add Music. So wherever you place your playhead, you can click on this and then this menu shows up. You want to add music from your uploads, so your own music if you uploaded your stuff, or music from the stock media. If you choose stock media, it's quite easy. You just click in here. This panel shows up to search for music, and you can use all of these many, many tracks from the stock library. I'm just going to choose this one. You click plus, and look at this. It's going to download that file to the project and add it right there where the playhead was. That doesn't mean you have to leave it there. You can move it around. You can click and drag it like this to stick it to the beginning of the episode or whatever you want to do. Now, there is one way to add the music for the intro. And before I do that, I want to show you how you can add stuff that you upload. So let's delete this one, select it and click backspace or delete. And then if you click again, it's going to say, you know, I want to upload music myself. So click on this one. And here I already uploaded a file in my audio section, but I can also click to upload a new one. So I've got some tracks in here from my piano improvisations. Click on one of them and click open. And that's going to upload the file to your studio library in Riverside, which means you can access it later. And after a couple of seconds of processing, it's going to be available for you to add down there again in your project. There it is. Click on it and it is down there in the bottom section. You may need to wait for a little bit to finish processing that file. And there's the file. You can still adjust the timing and trim the beginning and the end of the file by just dragging and moving the beginning or the end of the file. And if you need to see things more clearly, you can zoom in with Command and Mouse Wheel or Control and Mouse Wheel on Windows, and it will show you the waveform in there. And if you want to start the music at a later time, you can just click on that and just go and trim the music like this. And then you adjust the timing right there and you move it forward. One little trick that I have is when I want to add the music for the intro part, obviously this is the beginning of the episode, I don't have my intro yet. So if I want to put the music in or the intro, I can click on this plus, this big rectangle in here, and I can either add an empty section. And if I do that, it's going to be like 5 seconds long. And then there you go. I can grab the music and shift it forward like this. And that's going to be like a break, kind of pause in my intro. Or I can click again and add my actual intro in there. And I already uploaded that in my uploads. So click upload and I go to the video section. I've got my intro animation there. I'm just going to click that and insert it. And if that one has its own music, which is often the case, you can actually fix that by just removing the music. So again, Command and Mouse Wheel. I'm going to zoom out a bit. I want to see the end of it. Click on that segment and then go to the volume and just mute that out. That's one step. And then secondly, you see my music is now down here. I can click to access the music and just move that at the beginning right there. So now my music, my new music, is going to play while that video is playing. Watch this. So there you go, that's my animation for the beginning of my live streams. 100 seconds to wait. Another thing that you may want to do is actually fade the music out as it's finishing or as you're starting your show. You can do that by just going and first of all, decide where you want the music to actually be over. So you may have to adjust the ending a bit. So just drag that and shift it forward until, let's say, a few seconds after I started talking, right? So if I want to fade the music out, it's very easy. I can click on the music file itself and then go to the volume control up here above the timeline and open that. And you see you've got two things. I can fade in the music. So I'm going to fade it in by, you know, 3 seconds and fade it out over 5 seconds, for example. And also you can adjust the overall volume of the music using the volume control over here. I'm just going to leave it at 100 now. So watch this. In the timeline, you will now see this little line going down, indicating that that's where the music is fading out. I think it's actually too late, so I'm just going to make it even shorter like this. So now the music should fade out over my speech. Hello, Cristi here. Today I want to talk to you about the preferred. There you go. That's how you fade the music out. So you can control now different elements on the timeline and have music or sound playing in the background and controlling that as well. You can also access the volume and the fade out controls in these three dots at the end of the music track. Just go to volume and effects and you have the same controls over there. And if you need to replace this file with a different one, let's say I don't like this music, I want to change it, I can click in here and say replace. And I'm going to replace with another file I uploaded. So it's going to open the uploads panel there and I'm going to click this file in here and look at that. By the way, the duration resets. So even if you have made the previous file shorter, it's going to expand again to fit the new file, but the fade controls are maintained. So if I want to make that short again, I'm going to just drag the end and just go all the way there. But if you zoom in, you notice that the fade out is maintained across the files that you're switching. So there you go. This is how you add background music in Riverside. It's quite easy to do. I'm hoping that in the future, Riverside adds more tracks like this so that we can do more fancy effects with the multi-track editor, including overlaying several music files. This video is kindly sponsored by Riverside, and if you would like to try Riverside for free, there's a link in the description, and if you want to subscribe to Riverside, there is a coupon for you as well in the description, Cristi15 for a 15% discount. Give it a try and see how you like it.